So here, inside the bulb, there is no air. There is no air. So here, this is what we're doing here. Create Boolean. Click on that. And Boolean operation. Operation, here the default is unite. No, let's change that. Subtract. Subtract. And a target box. Target bodies. Let's choose the air box. So here, target means the big one. You know, when we do subtraction, something subtracts something. So here, this is called target. All right. So here, not selected. Click on that. Click on air box. Apply. All right. So our target bodies is the air box. Two bodies. Ball. Right? The two body is the ball. So here we're gonna use a big air box, subtracts the ball. The ball. And here, very important, preserve two bodies. Yes. Alright. If you don't do that, as soon as you do the subtraction, the ball will be gone. Right? We want to keep that. The bulb is generating heat. It's a very important part. So here, make sure you check the target body as the air box. Two body is the bulb, and make sure preserve the two body. Preserve the bulb. Right? Once we do that, generate. Now, this time, if I click on the bulb, it's still there. It's still there. If I click on the air box, as soon as I put the mouse here, you will see. Maybe you cannot see it. This dashed line represent, you know, there is a hole. There is a hole in the middle of this air box. Right? So now I have clearly two solid, two domains. Let's call it two domains. One is called bulb. It is a solid domain. We're gonna specify heat generation there. The other one is the air box. It's a fluid domain with air. So now we have two domains. One is solid domain, one is fluid domain. And we're gonna specify that in Fluent. All right, that's all we wanna do. Okay. Save project. I would like to put this on the desktop. I have several projects already, so let's give it a new name. It's called Bulb Only, Bulb-Only. So here in this project, there is only Bulb. Next, yes.
Sorry, I just got here. If someone has a beige Nissan, your lights are still on.
Thank you. All right. Next step, let's create a mesh. Something happened, so my view is messed up. But anyway, this is the geometry. This is the geometry. Go to outlines, so you will see here. One thing, the first step I want you to do is, here there is something called connection. Contacts. Click on contact. This is the picture. It shows the contact. Contact of what? Contact of these two domains. One is called the bulb. The other one is called the air box. And here, this represents the contact domain, the contact between these two domains. And this is what I would like to do. So here first, let's delete that. Because what we're gonna do is, we are gonna manually specify the interface between these two domains. It's a very critical step. When you have a fluid domain and a solid domain, or maybe two solid domains, or maybe two fluid domains. In the case you have two domains and there is a contact surface, actually, after we do the subtraction, there are two faces which are at the same place. One is from the ball side, the outer surface on the ball. The other one is from the airbox side, is the surface of the ball. All right? So here you have two faces, and you have two faces, and inside the fluid, you must specify these two. They are the interface. They're the interface. So fluid will understand, oh, this is the interface between this fluid domain and this solid domain. Because it's the interface, no boundary condition will be specified there. No boundary condition. The solution, the solver should take care of itself. Should take care of this, all right? So it's critical we specify after any subtraction. So you have two domains. After you do the subtraction, and the interface between these two domains, one from one side, the other one from the other side, actually they're the same face. It's just from, one is from the ball side, the other one is from the airbox side. And we must specify this as interface inside the fluent. So fluent understand, okay, this is interface. There is no boundary condition there. We don't specify anything, and solution through this solver will take care of it. All right. So this is what we do. So go to the geometry. So let's look at the geometry. First, let's specify the surface from the ball side. Well, here we cannot see the ball. All right, this is what we do. Here the default is pick a face. So pick this face, right click, hide this face. It's blocking my view, so hide this. Right click, hide this face, and then later on we can get it back. So now let's specify the face from the ball side. So go back to here. Let's paint the face. All right, top one. Hold the control key. Paint all the faces. Now we have three, the cap, the bottom, and the cylinder. So here, right click, create name selection. Now we have done this several times. So here, right click, create name selection. Click on that, and let's call this ball faces. All right, so this is the face from the ball side. Now let's specify the same face from the airbox side. All right, so this is what we do. So go back to the outline, geometry, expand that, and this time, let's hide the ball. Let's hide the geometry. Let's hide the ball. So all the faces we see is from the airbox side. So ball, right click, hide body. So now everything we see is from the airbox side. So go back to the graphics. We're still picking the surface. Notice this time when I click on that, the color does not change to green anymore. So here, this is the face from the airbox side. I want everyone to understand this concept. All right. Okay. So there is slight change. You can see after you click. click on that, hold down the control key. Middle part, bottom part. Right click, create name selection. Airbox, ball, faces. All right, so I remind myself, this is the face from the airbox side. The other one is the face from the ball side, all right? Now let's go back to the offline. So here, let's show this again. Show body. Now it's back. It's back. All right. Before we generate the mesh, the ball is very small compared to the airbox. So here we need to specify the grid resolution or the mesh size for this ball. We cannot use a single size for the airbox and the ball. The ball is small. So we need a fine mesh to represent this ball, this geometry. All right. If we don't do that, the solution will not converge because of my personal experiences. So here, make sure that let's specify some mesh resolution. So here, go to the outline, click on mesh, go back to the graphics. Faces, right click, insert, sizing. Here it says face sizing. Expand that. So notice here we're going to specify the face sizing for the three faces here. Element size. Let's do not use default. You know, notice the radius of this cylinder is 2 centimeters. So here, let's specify a size which is good enough, is small enough to represent this geometry. All right. So if the diameter is 2 centimeters, if we use 1 centimeter, that's too big. All right. So here, in order to resolve that, must be smaller than 0.2. Let's give it a 1/10. So here, 0.002. No, that's 2 millimeter. 2 meter. So here, I tried this, so here it seems it works. So 0.2 centimeter. No, this is wrong. 0.2. All right, it should be 2 millimeter, 2 millimeter, 0.2 centimeter. Okay. All right, after we have that, let's